Hey everybody, it's Angie and welcome to Hot and Flashy. Today's video is going to be my January faves and fails. I can't believe another month has gone by. Where is the time going? But here we are in February already, and so I thought I'd round up for you everything that I tried last month and tell you what I thought about it. Some of these products were sent to me as PR by the company. Some of it I purchased, and so I'll let you know which is which, but it doesn't really make a difference as far as me critiquing it. When companies send me things, it's at their own risk. You know, you take your chances, and you could get a good review, you could get a bad review. I tried a lot of makeup, not too much skincare, and a couple of miscellaneous things. So the first one is a new eye pencil that I picked up. This is a longtime fave brand of eye pencil. It's the Urban Decay 24/7 glide-on eye pencils, but I got it in a new color. This one is in mushroom. It's such a pretty color, and if you're, you know, getting older, as we all are, and black eyeliner is just not working for you anymore, it's sometimes nice to lighten up your eyeliner color a little bit to like a dark gray or a dark brown or a taupe. And this one is really pretty, and I especially love it with the eyeshadow look that I have going on today. It's just the right kind of satin finish, so I really love that, and I'm wearing that today. It's such a creamy pencil that it's really easy to put on, especially if you have like older, you know, eyelids where your skin is a little crepey, and you know, I mean, you know how it is. Just, you know what I'm saying, right? You need a softer pencil to get a smooth line, and it's a nice soft pencil, and then you can smudge it out a little bit, so it just gives a really, really pretty look. And then this next item isn't makeup, but it's something that I picked up at Nordstrom because I noticed that they had a great price on a kit of two. I've actually been interested in one of these things for a while, but I felt like the price point was too high on it. So it's the Sigma Go-Go Clean Duo Brush Cleaning Kit, and it's for cleaning your makeup brushes, and it comes with this awesome brush cleaning mat, and it also comes with a full size of their Sigmatic brush shampoo. This kit is on sale right now for $25. So this is $25, this is $15, so it's like getting this for free. This brush shampoo is so good. It's making it a pleasure to clean my brushes. I've cleaned all my brushes with it in the last couple of weeks, and I've had so much fun. I've been like Miss Brush Cleaner. It's an oil-based product, and so it gets all the makeup out of your brushes, and they look good as new. Like, my white brushes come out perfectly white when I use this. And this little guy is awesome. It sits in the bottom of your sink, so this little cutout is for around the drain. And then it's got all these different textures on here for different types of brushes. These rinsy parts really help to rinse the soap out of the brushes. Plus, it keeps my hands out of the water, and it's amazing when you see all the makeup running out of there and down there. It's just, you'll be shocked. You'll be shocked if you get one. Okay, so let's move on. So I tried four different eyeshadow palettes this month. The fave out of the four is this Violet Voss Pro palette. This is the Taupe Notch palette. So you know me, I like the cooler eyeshadow colors, and I'm always looking for an awesome taupe palette. Yes, I did buy this. I saw it on the Sephora website. It's a $45 palette, so it's not a hugely expensive price point, you know, for 20 pans. So there's 8 mattes, and that leaves 12 shimmers, which is a lot, but it's fine because they're not like glittery shimmers. They're just very nice kind of satiny shimmers, and I really, really like how they look on the eyelid. It also has colors like Bestest and Royal and Taupe, and those are just nice mid-tone mattes that you would use deep in the crease or a little bit above the crease. So over the course of the last month that I've been using this, I did do a gold look, I did do more of a pinky look, I did do just standard brownie taupey look, and I did today more of like a purpley look. So I am happy with the variety that you can get out of it, even though it doesn't look on the surface like it offers a lot of variety. I was really happy with like the color payout and the blendability. Of the palettes that I tried this month, this is definitely my favorite. Let's move on to primers. I discovered a couple of primers that I really like this month. One is the Catrice Prime and Fine. I picked it up to do a drugstore versus high-end tutorial, and I was looking for something to put on the drugstore side against the Hourglass Veil Mineral Primer, and so I picked this just because it was kind of a white primer that had kind of the same look and feel as this, and I really love this. I've like been using this instead of this now, and that's, you know, that Hourglass is hugely expensive. This doesn't have the same ingredients, but that's okay with me. This is a silky matte finish, long-lasting, oil-free, pore-refining, anti-shine base. I am going to study it up close and personal for my pores and primer video that I will have coming up for you in the late winter, early spring. Definitely. I know I've been talking about it for a year now, but that's because I didn't find anything last year that was any good. And I feel like this year I am finally finding things that actually do something for your pores and keep it that way after you put on makeup. Like most things, you put it on and then the second you put on makeup, forget it. There goes the pore reducing. And so what's the point? Anyway, I feel like I've tried a few things lately that have actually kept my pores a little bit minimized even after I apply makeup, and this was one of them. So really liking that one. Another one that I tried is the Revlon Photo Ready Perfecting Primer, and I've used these two in a couple of the Foundation Fridays that I've done recently, and I like them both a lot, but I think I like the Catrice just a little bit better. Now the Revlon primer definitely has like more silicones in it. It's got quite a few actually, but it is kind of the mix of ingredients that I like in a primer. It's that silicone, water, isodecane kind of thing that I think works. What I like best about this one is that when I'm testing it with a thicker foundation, they don't work with like a really thick primer. And so the ones that are full-on silicone, you know, don't really work because it's too thick for me. So I like this one because it's a little thinner underneath. And I like this Revlon one. This one seemed a little bit thinner. Okay, so I tried a couple of bronzers and face palette kind of things. The best one that I tried was from Makeup Geek. This was sent to me as PR. This is their Flawlessly Ever After Fair Lady face palette. They actually sent me, I think there were three or four of these in different shades. So these come in, you know, light, medium, and dark for different complexions. These are so pretty. This blush especially, I love this blush. But I like it that they give you a cool blush and a warm blush in here. I'm actually wearing all of these today. I did both of the blushes. This is my favorite because I love like a peachy kind of peony color that's so pretty. But this one, you know, sometimes when I'm doing more of a taupey, purpley eye look, I like to have more of a cool blush. So first I put on this one just because I always, you know, just because I like that one better. I put it on, I was like, ooh, oh no, it's a little too peachy for this eyeshadow. So then I switched to this one and just put that over the top. And even just layering them, they're just not heavy. They don't go on like the little bullseye of pink on your cheek. You know, you want your blush to be blended and you want your products to be blendable, and these are so blendable. They're just beautiful, and I've got to say I'm having a little love affair with the Makeup Geek stuff, and this bronzer is so gorgeous. It blends so beautifully and it's nice and sheer, so it's not going to make you look like, you know, you tried to tan up too much and you look ridiculous. The one kind of the weakest thing in here I think is probably the highlighter, just because I like more of a lighter highlighter, I guess, but this one just blends in really beautifully. If you're into like a really, really subtle highlight that's more like the same color as your blush, it's really nice. I tried the Physicians Formula BB Bronze Booster. I was actually trying to buy the butter bronzer that everyone raves about, and I got to Ulta and I couldn't remember. I thought BB stood for butter bronzer, so I bought this one. So I got it home and I was like, wait, I don't think this is the right thing. And so I went back on Ulta to look at the Physicians Formula bronzers. And do you know that they make 13 different bronzers? I mean, they have bronzers galore. But I did read the reviews on the butter bronzer and I don't really think I would like it. A lot of the complaints about it, while it does get glowing reviews, a lot of the complaints about it are the scent. Apparently it smells like suntan lotion or coconut, and it's very, very strong. And so I think for me, I may have gotten the right one because I actually really like this. This one is more of a matte bronzer. I think a lot of them, including the butter bronzer, have like a shimmer to them. And I like my bronzer to be matte. I don't really like my forehead, and you know, like I use it to contour softly around my face, and I don't really like that stuff to be like too shiny or too shimmery. Came in a few shades, of course. This one is the light to medium. So if you're pale and you want to just bronze up a little bit so that you look a little more lifelike in the dead of winter, these are nice. I like that one a lot. So that was a good one. So should we move on to the lippies? My favorite one is this Stila Stay All Day Sheer Liquid Lipstick. I like the idea of a liquid lipstick that was going to be sheer because, you know, you put them on and they're just so opaque and they all are kind of matte and drying looking. Well, not all of them. Some are good. But here's the benefits. Sheer matte liquid lipstick, 12-hour wear, lightweight formula, won't bleed or transfer, enriched with vitamin E and avocado oil to help hydrate and nourish the lips. So I really like this. A couple of times I've worn it, I didn't feel that it was overly drying. It does feel slightly dry after a couple of hours, and so I do like to put something else on top of it that makes my lips feel moisturized. I'm having a little love affair with the Buxom Full On Lip Creams. This one is in Blushing Margarita. I love the cooling sensation, especially when I go outside and it's cold out, and then it just feels so good. But I layer this over this, and oh my god, I love the two together. So this color is so pretty, and it doesn't feather into your lip wrinkles, and it's so easy to apply. So today I put it on this morning, then I went upstairs and took my shower and washed my face. Was still on when I came out of the shower. I haven't reapplied this, and it's still on and it still looks good. So I've been very happy with this product. So that's a winner of the lip things that I tried. Now the losers were the NYX Powder Puff Lippy. I bought two of these because I was so excited about them. I thought they looked like such an amazing product. What I like about these is the colors. The colors in these are gorgeous, so well curated. This first one is in Best Buds, and then the other one I got, oh, I didn't even open this one. I tried this one first. Shoot, yeah, you know what? I'm probably gonna return this one, so I'm not even gonna be able to swatch it for you. But this applicator, it's just too big and too puffy, and you can't get it on your lips very well. I did try to line my lips and then put this on, and it still didn't work very well. These actually go on feeling really nice. They feel actually oily for something that's supposed to be like a powder, and they're supposed to really stain your lips. I found these to be very, very drying within like 5 minutes. My lips felt dry. You know, you can still rub them together and feel that oily feeling, but deep down it feels so dry. They weren't long lasting either, so didn't love those. Two things that were sent to me in PR that I was very hopeful for. One was this Pixi Matte Last Liquid Lipstick. This one is in Au Naturel. I thought that was a really pretty color. It reminded me a lot of this lipstick that I wore actually in the last couple of videos. That you guys love this lipstick. This is the Urban Decay Vice Lipstick in Fuel. So very similar, only a little brighter, you know, than this guy. So I really like the color on it. I wore this on the second day of testing the Bobbi Brown makeup, which was okay. It was kind of a mixed bag. I definitely had it on kind of crooked. The one thing I can say about it is that it really stayed in place. It didn't creep up into lip wrinkles, so that was good. It was really, really drying feeling and really, really dry looking. So my lips look cracked and ugh, gross. Just, you know, old and dry and yucky. All right, let's look at under eye concealer next. This is the Urban Decay All Nighter Under Eye Concealer. This was a big new launch in January, and Urban Decay did send me the entire line, so I have it in all the colors. I was really disappointed in this because I kind of liked the All Nighter foundation. I felt like that was pretty good, but this just didn't do it for me. Number one, this is so ridiculously expensive. It is $29 for 0.12 ounces. Compare that to the Tarte Shape Tape, which came in third in my under eye concealer testing video, so a pretty good product. This is $27 for 0.33 ounces. So this is twice the size of this, and it costs less. I don't want to offend Urban Decay because I am on their PR list and they send me everything. So they don't pick and choose things to send me based on my age or, you know, whatever, the demographic. So I kind of like that about Urban Decay. I do want to stay on their list. I do like a lot of their products, but this one just did not do it for me. It's a very dry formula, so it's a little bit difficult to apply because it dries and sets up so quickly. So you can't like put it under both eyes and then blend one and blend the other, because by the time you're done blending this one is dry and it's stuck where it is. And if you try to blend it, it'll be a disaster. I did find that in the beginning, it was very opaque coverage. If you have really dark circles, this could work for you. And it was very smoothing. Like when I put it on and then set it with a setting powder, it was so smooth and so opaque, at least in the beginning. The one side I left without the setting powder, it was just a hot mess. It settled into every wrinkle and every crevice. But I find that is universally true of all under eye concealers, even my favorites, my holy grails, they do that. So you absolutely have to set it. I know a lot of older people, more mature people, don't like to put powder under there because they think it makes their concealer look worse, but I find it makes your concealer look so much better. You don't need a lot, just a little, but you do need setting powder. So anyway, it did look nice at first. Unfortunately, it didn't wear well and it felt so drying. The other thing is that the colors oxidize a lot, and so it's a good thing they sent me every color, because it took me like 4 or 5 tries to find a color that was reasonable for me. Here are all the shades that are like kind of in my shade range, and I tried all of these. I swatched 4 of them on my hand, and you can see when they dried how much they oxidized. So I think the first color I tried, it went on and I thought it was good, and then within, you know, half an hour it was so dark and it didn't match my makeup and my under eyes looked orange and weird, and I was like, oh gosh, you know, it's just not a great product. And then the last thing that I wanted to talk about in this video is the Burt's Bees makeup, which I also tried this month. I was going to do a Foundation Friday on the Burt's Bees Goodness Glows, but I hate doing a Foundation Friday where I hate the foundation because I only do 2 videos a week, and so I hate wasting one on a product that I absolutely hate. It is not possible for this to look good. Whether you wear sunscreen or don't wear sunscreen, whether you wear primer or don't wear primer, whether you put it on with a sponge, a brush, your fingers, it doesn't matter. This is horrible. Horrible. It's the worst looking foundation I have ever tried. I did buy a few of the other items from the line to try. I was going to do a whole Burt's Bees review because I figured it was going to be good. I also got this mattifying powder. This was awful. This, you put it on and it looks like you put metal, like some kind of white metallic powder on, and once you put it on, it does not budge. You can't blend it out, you can't get rid of it. It just leaves you with these weird, shiny, metallic white patches around your face. I've seen everyone else raving about the blush. It's fine, but it's no better than any other drugstore blush. I don't know. I'm so mad about the foundation that I can't even be nice about the blush. The blush actually is fine. It's a pretty blush. You know, it's not earth-shattering. It does come in a few different shades. This one is 1210 Shy Pink. Let's see, what else? I also picked up the eyeliner and the mascara. They're fine. The eyeliner is actually very hard. You know, like I was talking before about the Urban Decay eyeliner, which is very creamy and easy to put on your older eyelids. Not easy to put on your older eyelids, this guy. I'll put it right next to the Urban Decay just to show you the color. It is midnight gray. So it's pretty color. It's not full on black, but it is pretty dark. And I don't recall it smudging or, you know, going all over the place. Seemed to stay in the waterline fairly well. The mascara I actually thought was good. I like the formula. It made my lashes look nice. I don't remember it chipping or flaking or smudging. So I think the mascara was nice. Yeah, so these two were decent products. I felt like probably the 3 winners of the things in the Burt's Bees line that I tried were the blush, the mascara, and the eyeliner pencil. All right, so that's it for today's faves and fails. It was a long one, but we had 2 months worth of makeup to go over. So I hope you found the video helpful and informative. If you did, give it a like and subscribe to my channel. And so thanks everybody for watching. You know, I always appreciate your time. So have a great day, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.